Okay, so today's session, let's discuss about the remodeling concept. And in this is a project number. This is a project that let's discuss the remodeling part now. And for the remodeling part, actually, first of all, we have to understand why we have to go for remodeling. Remodeling is a concept in which we are going to remodel a cube, and the remodeling concept is only applicable for cubes. Okay, and remodeling concept, what exactly is the purpose of remodeling is, let's say if we have a cube, and this cube is there in a particular, this is a cube, and in this cube we have cube 1, and this cube is there in the development server, and this development server data, whatever we have, development server. And now let's say we have the different types of servers. This is the quality server, and this is the development server, this is the quality server and production server. Now what happens is, normally this is one of the differences that we have between BW and BI. So this remodeling concept was introduced only in BI. Before BI 7.0, we didn't have the concept of remodeling. In that case, what used to happen is, let's say you have built a cube with couple of characteristics and key figures or what it might be, and you have moved it to quality and it was approved, and then you moved it to production, that's fine. Now once it has gone to production, you might have loaded the data for a couple of years, like let's say 2 years or 3 years, you have loaded the data into the cube. Now this data that we have in the cube is very much there, but there is a requirement by the client in which he has to add couple of characteristics and key figures, and he wants to modify couple of characteristics and key figures, he wants to also delete some characteristics and key figures. All these things have to be done, means those things have to be done in the development server. Now when you change or modify the cube, then that cube will go to the quality, and from the quality to production. Now once the modified cube goes to the production, it overrides the existing cube. So existing cube is with data, 2 years or 3 years of data, but the recent one which we are moving into the production is empty. You cannot move the cube with data. Okay, whenever, even if you have filled the cube with data here in the quality or development, when you are moving to the quality, it will be empty. So you cannot move the data from here to here. Only the structure of the cube moves. Now from here to here again we will move the cube. Now then what is happening here in the cube, when it goes to the cube, in the production, it will become empty. Again we need to refill that data, all the cube data again in the production. That's what has to happen in the real time, which is a very major drawback. Okay, so now in this, what we are going to do is, we are going to move it from here to here, here to here, right? So what are we going to do is, we are going to create a remodeling attachment here. We're going to say remodeling rule one. Now this remodeling rule one is attached to the existing cube. You are not going to do any modifications to the cube. Now this only remodeling rule, you are moving it to the quality. Remodeling rule one. So this same remodeling rule, whatever we have created here, will be remodeling rule. Okay, from here to here, okay, the same remodeling rule will move to the production as well. Okay, so from development to quality, quality to production. Okay, this remodeling rule will go to the production. Now what happens is, the existing cube is untouched. Okay, it remains as it is, and with this cube one, the remodeling rule 1 is attached. Okay, so this remodeling rule 1 has been moving from development to quality, quality to production. Okay, and now what happens? Only those modified characters or key figures might be empty, but other fields will be existing. For example, if you have already 1 crore records, all the 1 crore records, if there are 4 characteristics, 4 key figures in the old cube, now you have added 2 more characteristics. The 2 more characteristics for the existing 1 crore records will be blank. But from now onwards, you can rewrite the transformations, you can rewrite the DTP and load the data into the all the fields, all the info objects. This is what is the concept of remodeling. So let's do the remodeling for a particular cube. Yeah, it will be added. And I mean, the fields will be added or the info objects will be added, but the data will not be there, obviously. So for example, you have employee details, in that Aadhaar card has been made mandatory, so you have added Aadhaar card field, but info object, but that will be blank for the existing fields, existing records. Now let's go ahead with this Jaguar. In the Jaguar we have a cube, so right click on this and additional functions, remodeling. You need to come to the remodeling. This is very important concept in BI 7.0. It wasn't there in the older modules, okay, older versions. Remodeling. And in this remodeling, just say okay, you can have to take a backup before doing this. And remodeling rule, we have to name some remodeling rule. Let's say JHS_JAG, and click on create. Now once we click on this create, now here Jaguar IC or Jaguar remodeling. Now in this we'll just say transfer, and in this we have all the characteristics and key figures. Now what is that you want to do here? Let's say we want to add a new info object characteristic. For that we need to click on this button, click this, and in this we have to mention the add characteristic. So what is the characteristic that you want to add, and to which dimension do you want to add? So I want to add 0 country, and to which dimension I want to add? I want to add it to IC1, because there's only one dimension, transfer. Okay, and then save it. And then you can schedule this, and obviously you can do it for key figures as well. Okay, right click on this create, you can create a new one, select this, just click on this button, and in this add key figure. So now we are adding a new key figure, so we can have 0 date. Okay, 0 date. You can check if it is there or not. Or we can go for physical of risk here. You can go for 0 cal D. Okay. Otherwise, do you know any key figure which you already created for something which we can use here? I had something called tax, I guess. I'm adding this tax amount, save it. Now we would like to modify a particular Jaguar salary. Okay, this salary we want to modify. So again click on this, again modify or replace. You can go for replace, you can replace this with something else, but I'm doing only two operations as of now. You can also very well you do other operations as well. Whatever you do, once you have fixed that, you have to click on schedule. So once we schedule, it means that this has been start immediately. When this job runs and it is successfully running, then this fields or the info objects that we have added or modified or deleted will be automatically added up in your queue, existing queue. Okay. Oh, 0 unit is required for that. For this, it has to be a 0 unit has to be added. Okay, let's simplify this. We had KME I would like to add this one. Okay, so this is replaced by that, and now I think it will be done. So schedule, start immediately. So when we start this job monitor, click on the monitoring button so that we can see whether this is successfully done or not. Here we'll see whether the data has been. You can parallelly, you can go ahead and check the cube whether it has been added or not. And this. All the transformations and DDP have to be rerun. So in the dimension, the country key has been added. In the key figures, this SM underscore date of joining also been added. So a couple of fields can be added like this. And once it has been done, what we need to do is we need to transport this particular, you need to transport only this particular remodeling rule. So how do we transport it to quality and production is, go to the remodeling, write transport request. So we are writing the transport request only for this remodeling rule. So for that, we'll go for transport request. And in this, you need to always save it in a package when you have to write a transport request. So when you say that JHS and just say save, and once it's been saved and say okay, now once this successfully done, now we need to go into SE09 transaction and check if that particular remodeling rule request number that we have generated is existing. For transport organizer, either you can go into SE09 transaction or SE10 transaction. Now in this, we can see the request number here, create new request. Okay, so this in the under this we have the remodeling rule. Under which request did we save it?